Hello dear students, so today we are going to continue our lecture on free damped vibration. Okay, so yesterday we have solved one example based on free damped vibration, in which we have used the equations of logarithmic decay, time period, etc. Now today we are going to solve example based on free damped vibration based on logarithmic decrement, damping factor, damping coefficient, critical damping coefficient, etc. We will see in today's lecture. So moving to example number 2 of free damped vibration. Okay, so now what this statement says: in a single degree damped vibration system, a suspended mass of 8 kg makes 30 oscillation in 18 seconds. So there is a mass of 8 kg which is doing 30 oscillation in time period is given 18 seconds. Okay, the amplitude decreases to 0.25 of the initial value after 5 oscillations. Find number 1 spring stiffness, number 2 logarithmic decrement, number 3 spring stiffness, number 4 logarithmic decrement, and then damping coefficient. So these 4 things we have to determine in this example. Okay, so moving towards the solution, so first of all we are writing the data which is given to you in the example. So first mass is given to you 8 kg, then number of oscillation is given to you, then there is one condition given to you. Okay, after 5 amplitude it decreases to 0.25, so it is x5 is equal to 0.25 x0. This relationship given to you. Okay, so now we know that he is in 30 oscillation is doing in 18 seconds, so we can directly find out the time period. So time period is 18 divided by 30, so it is 0.6 सेकंड पर साइकिल. तो एक साइकिल कंप्लीट करने के लिए उसको 0.6 सेकंड लग रहे हैं, ऐसा हम प्रूव कर सकते हैं. ओके, सो टाइम पीरियड वैल्यू इज 0.6 नाउ. ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट थिंग वी हैव टू डिफाइन इज स्प्रिंग स्टिफनेस के. ओके, नाउ वी ऑल नो दैट व्हाट इज द जनरलाइज इक्वेशन ऑफ नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी इक्वेशन इज ओमेगा एन इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट के बाय एम. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू डिफाइन द वैल्यू ऑफ ओमेगा एन. द वैल्यू ऑफ एम इज विथ अस. Okay, so we can directly find out the value of k by using this particular equation. Okay, so first we are going to find natural frequency. Okay, now we have the value of time period, so we can easily find the value of frequency. Okay, now from finding out the natural frequency, there is an equation omega n is equal to 2 pi f. Okay, or we can say that frequency f is equal to frequency f is equal to omega divided by 2 pi. Okay, this is the general relation we have studied in the physics also. Okay, so directly we can find out the value of fn by using the equation fn is equal to 1 upon tp. so 1 upon tp, so we can find out omega n by using 2 pi divided by tp. okay, so omega n value of natural frequency is 10.47 radian per second. okay, so first thing we have find it. After that we are using this equation omega n is equal to under root k by m. We can directly find out the value of k, stiffness newton per meter. It is 876 newton per meter. Okay, from this equation we have the value of omega n, we have the value of mass m 8 kg, so we can directly finding out the value of stiffness k here. Okay, so moving further. Okay, now second thing we have to define the logarithmic decrement. Okay, so equation of logarithmic decrement, delta is equal to 1 upon n log e base 2 x1 divided by xn. So by putting the values of x1 and xn, it is all given to you. Okay, so we can directly find out the delta is equal to 0.27. okay, it has no values. Okay, no unit, it is the unitless. Logarithmic decrement is the term is unitless. Okay, so moving further, now we have to find out damping factor. Now what is the generalized equation of damping factor? We can say that damping factor generalized equation is c divided by cc. damping, it is the ratio of damping coefficient to critical damping coefficient. But here value of damping factor is unknown to us, value of critical damping factor is also unknown to us. So from that equation we cannot find out the value of zeta damping factor. Okay, so another equation, this is very important equation. ये जो केस होता है, इन दिस टाइप ऑफ केसेस वी हैव टू यूज दिस इक्वेशन ऑफ zeta and delta. Means it is the equation of relationship between the damping factor and logarithmic decrement. So the equation is delta divided by under root of 4 pi square minus delta square, where this zeta is damping factor and delta is the logarithmic decrement. This delta is logarithmic decrement. So this is very important equation. So after putting the values of delta here, so we can directly find out the value of zeta, damping factor is equal to 0.042. So we can say that it is less than 1. In previous lecture we have studied that the value of zeta, if it is less than 1, it is underdamped system. If it is equal to 1, it is critical damped system. If it is greater than 1, then it is overdamped system. Okay, got it? So we can here write down that it is the 0.042, it is less than 1. So we can say that it is the underdamped system. Okay, good. So three things we have defined. Logarithmic decrement हमने find कर लिया, damping factor हमने find कर लिया, spring stiffness भी हमको ये example में find कर लिया. Now last thing is remaining, damping coefficient. Okay. Now we will use the equation of damping factor, zeta is equal to C divided by CC. So now value is zeta is known to us, value of C we have to define, and CC, there is an equation of CC is equal to 2m omega n. So we have the value of m and omega n. So putting the value of m omega n here, so we can directly find out the value of C. So C is equal to 7.03. Now remember this equation, unit of this C, damping coefficient, is Newton into second per meter. It is not Newton meter per second, it is Newton into second per meter. So this is the value of C. So this way we have defined the damping coefficient. Now this example may be asked in 4 marks, may be asked in 7 marks by determining one more parameter. Okay. So this is very important equation. Please try to solve other example based on this by using reference books or anything, any other platforms. Okay. So if any doubts for this lecture, please write down in the comment box. Okay. So thank you so much for attending today's lecture. Thank you.